So I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys remember this scorpion, right? The one that I unboxed. Yes, the one with the clipped off stinger. Yes, I know that a lot of you guys remember it because I've been getting a lot, like a ton. And when I say a lot, I mean a lot, like a lot of questions and comments asking me for an update on her. Like, is she okay? Did she make it? Please make another video on her. Yeah, so today's video is going to be that another video on her. Now, sorry for the delay. I was meant to make this video a while back, but you know, if you guys follow me for quite some time, you'll know that I procrastinate a lot. I'm just a lazy person in general. I never got good grades in school because I don't like to study. I was just being lazy. Okay, why am I even telling you guys this? But yeah, anyways, I've been getting some other comments as well. And yes, Lil Nun, she did not eat because of her tail. Yep, it's been clipped off because these scorpions, unlike the Asian forest scorpion, you know the Asian forest scorpion? I just showed you a video not too long back, and Asian forest scorpions, they hunt with their pinchers. So they grab the food and then they start eating. However, these desert scorpions, they will have to use their stingers. Like when they grab the food with their pinchers, they will need to use that stinger to stun or envenomate, is that even a word? Place venom into that prey item before they start eating it. So unfortunately, this one had its tail clipped off, so it couldn't do that. And no, Jazz Park, we do not bring scorpions to the vet, especially ones with clipped tails. When the scorpion stinger is gone, it's gone. If you bring it to the vet, the vet's probably gonna laugh at you. So yeah, at least here they probably would. But anyways, here is the update on the scorpion. Here it is. Yes, as many of you guessed, she did pass away. And because, well, because of her stinger, because you can see over here, the stinger is clipped off. You can see it's not sharp anymore. Yeah, that's unfortunate because this is not going to be good enough for it to sting and kill its prey. Oh my gosh, I just broke. Yeah, this is because it's dried up, so it's very, very brittle. But yeah, I'm going to be preserving this specimen. Oh my gosh, yeah, I just broke the tail.
I'm a genius.
Whew, okay, but in a way, it's going to make it better because I'm going to be preserving it. You can see what's in its tail. It's pretty much hollow. The smell is not pleasant, but yeah. Now we can see its tail since it came off. Oh, by the way, this is my Avicularia Amazonica. It's somewhere in there. Yeah, I can't quite see. You can see its little toes over there. But yeah, that's not about this video. So here, you can see its tail. You see, at the tip of it? Yeah, that is definitely 100% clipped off. This previous owner, I don't know what to say to him because you're selling a scorpion with a clipped tail. How professional are you? Very, very disappointing. So I thought of preserving this little guy, I mean girl, into this container over here, but I don't know if it'll fit. Yeah, it should fit, but I'm not sure if it'll fit through the cap. I'm gonna have to wash this out because this had chili sauce inside. Yes, chili sauce, hot sauce. So I had to wash it, and it's soap water in here to get rid of all the oils. So now I'm gonna have to clean this off and I'll be back. So I've washed this container and, well, I tried to put her in and she just doesn't want to fit, unfortunately. So I guess I can't be using this bottle to preserve her. So I'm not quite sure what I'm going to be doing with her. I thought of like putting her in this and putting alcohol in here. I even bought needles, like literally. I went online and I bought these injection needles. Like, look at that. It's legit needles. It's like, yeah, legit needles, because I actually went to the vet and I asked him,
can I get a syringe and a needle?
And he was like,
I can't give you needles. Needles that have the sharp end.
So he clipped it off. Yeah, how helpful. Yeah, I know they're not supposed to give full needles because, you know, drug addicts, but I managed to get some online. No, I'm not a drug addict, okay? I wanted to use this to preserve this scorpion because I thought, what better way to remember it than to preserve it, right? So I bought this needle to put it onto this syringe and basically like to just inject it with alcohol so inside will be preserved as well. But since the scorpion can't fit in here, I'm gonna have to think of another way to try and preserve it. Yes, I know, a bigger container, but nah, I'm thinking of a different way instead of a wet specimen, because wet specimens are usually what I always do. So maybe something different for this one, I'm not quite sure. This was also supposed to be a preserving video, but I guess that is not turning out as how I planned, and I pretty much just wasted my money on these needles. So yeah. Plus, I broke off the tail, so what am I gonna do? Should I like super glue the tail back onto the scorpion? I don't know. So I guess this video is just about the update that you guys requested on the scorpion, not so much on the preserving, because I couldn't preserve it since it couldn't fit in here. I'm just gonna have to go out and buy a bigger container if I ever decide that I want to do a wet specimen, which I don't think so. I think I'm gonna try something different with this. I don't know. In the future video, not quite sure. But as for now, I think I'll just put this on my shelf or something while I think of what I'm gonna gonna do with it. Maybe I'll glue the tail back on, not too sure. Or maybe I'll just use this as an educational piece to show people what happens when you clip off a scorpion's tail. No, do not do that. I've met quite a few people, especially in my school, the one that I teach. When they get to know that I keep scorpions and tarantulas, they're like,
do you defang them? Do you take off the stinger?
I'm like, no, you don't do that. Especially my snakes. When they get to know that I have snakes, they're like,
do you take out their fangs?
I don't keep venomous snakes. Pissy? Yeah, I know, rear fang venomous. That guy is an exception, but he's pissy and his fangs are just pretty much useless to humans. Yeah, they're harmless. So yeah, I don't keep snakes with fangs, so I don't defang them. I mean, it's not like if I keep venomous, I'm gonna defang them. No, do not defang snakes. Do not de-stinger scorpions. De-stinger? Is de-stinger even a word? Do de-sting? I don't know. And do not defang tarantulas because they all need those things to live. If you're gonna decide to amputate or mutilate them or whatever word you wanna use, do expect them to die. I mean, you're not gonna get a lot out of that. They do best with what nature has provided them with, and if you're just gonna cut those things off, then you are one irresponsible owner and you just lost all of my respect. Just like this guy who sent me this scorpion. Yep, screw you, man. You're the worst person on this earth. If you're watching this, I hope you feel bad. So yeah, guys, I guess that is pretty much the end of this video, the end of my rant. I'm sorry, but you guys wanted an update, and well, here is the update. Not a very nice update. I mean, a lot of you guys already kinda knew that she was gonna die. I mean, I kinda knew that she was gonna die because these desert scorpions, they are very, very good eaters. As soon as you drop in the prey, they are there to grab and sting the prey, unlike the Asian forest scorpion, which is just like just waiting there, and sometimes food comes, it clips, sometimes it just doesn't clip. But yeah, these guys are very, very good eaters. So for one to just refuse food like that, it is very, very unlikely and very, very worrying. I kinda expected this one to go. I didn't contact the guy because I couldn't be bothered to even talk to him. It's not like anything's gonna change. He wasn't like some reputable vendor, he was just some random guy that I bought off, and I know that is kind of wrong of me also to just support some random dude, but he did not mention that this stinger has been clipped off. I mean, who would mention if they're selling a scorpion? For all you know, he was probably selling the scorpion because he clipped off the tail and the scorpion didn't want to eat for him. So he was scared it was gonna die and he'll lose money, so he just decided to sell it and get the money back, which is unbelievable. So yeah, like I mentioned, that is pretty much it for this video. Sorry for the bad update, but you're welcome for the update, and sorry for the delayed update. So yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to thumbs it up. If you didn't, feel free to thumbs it down. If you're new to this channel, subscribe, hit that notification bell so you'll know when the next update will be up, and hopefully it will not be a bad update like this. So yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace, and you guys take care. Oh yeah, the needles! I forgot about them! Should keep them before someone steps on them. I think that's why the doctor was like,
I'm gonna clip off this needle because I'm not gonna give needles to some irresponsible little kid.